Let's come to the authentication first quickly, and we're going to learn Postman after this. So we have support for basic auth. Most of the time you will be working with basic auth, right? So basic auth is nothing but a base 64 version of a username and password, right? And how you can use it. So basically, if you go to this authorization tab, you can see, let me show you if I have a basic auth example. Right, so you can have a basic auth here. For example, you can please ignore the user. So let me change that. Right, so in the basic auth you can add username and password. So if you add username and password, that will be used, right? Authentication is basically a way to check if the user is correct and if they whatever the information that we want, right? I want the information of this POT project with the issue number 2, and this is the object, this is the username and password is associated with this project. That's why we are getting this, right? So similarly, we have digest authentication. Digest authentication is nothing. So base64, again, anyone can, what they can do is that you can intercept your network and basically decode the base64 and check out your username and password. So it's not a secure way to do that, right? That's why we have a digest authentication. Digest authentication is nothing but a username password with a certain kind of encryption, right? So if you select digest here, we have username, password, right? And after that, you will see that we have some MD5 where we can add certain kind of information, more information, right? And it will be encrypted in an encrypted form. So between the network, no one can basically sniff your username and password, and only server will know how to decrypt it. And that's why it's one of the secure way, right? Now, after that, you will have a couple of more type of authentication, like authentication 1, 2, and couple of AWS signature, NDLM. Again, these are pretty much similar. You just required, for example, if you are using AWS signature, whenever you are creating a new machine, right? In the AWS, if you want to authenticate, or if you want to access this API, which has certain kind of a AWS signature, you require these things: session token, service name, AWS region. So you can add the region like US East and all, right? I don't have an example as of now, but if you required, I can show you. So NTLM, you can use. You require domain and workstation information. So again, it's a way to authenticate yourself, right? So if we talk about JWT is nothing but a structured tokens, right? So we call it JavaScript web tokens, and they are most of the time used for, again, you will have a random string. If you see, let me show you. So a long random string, where it is, let me see if I have a demo for this one. Go file upload. This is again a different one. So this is actually auth 2. You will see a long string in case of a JWT, which is basically have a structured way, which is again, server can understand what is the username and password in that case. They just want to avoid any kind of a username password. That's why they are providing you certain kind of a token in this case, right? So that's how authentication works. Awesome. So let's talk about the Postman object. And this is one of the important concept where most of the things you will be doing. So let's use a dummy API where it is. Right. Demo one, right? So I have told you that I have used JSON server for this one, and you can see a simple request, this one, right? If we do a get request, it will basically going to return this thing, right? So we have JSON response, right? We have multiple person, which is person one information. This is person two information. They are comma separated, if you see. And if you see this bracket, it basically means it's an array, right? And this is an object which contains key and value. So key and value. This JSON, we have different data types, like we have string, we have integers, we can have Boolean. For example, if I can add more thing, for example, we can have Boolean, right? In that case, true or false. That different type of a data types are basically supported in JSON, right? So now what we wanted to do is that, yes. Right. So let's understand the test part first. For how do we test this API, right? So we can go one by one. And if you see, Postman already provides certain kind of a snippets. If you see, we have a snippets library, right? The first test case that they have is the status code check. If you directly click it, right, it will basically add a, if you see, automatically code. So what exactly, let's understand this code. So Postman provides first thing, which is called as PM object, right? And this object contains multiple functions that you can directly use, right? So you can use PM.cookies, environment, expect, globals, information, and a test method, if you see test, right? And this test method, if you do square bracket, basically telling you the first will be the test name. What is the name of your test? And after that, we'll have a function and what you want to do in this, right? So typical structure of the Postman, how it works, guys, pay attention, make sure you are taking notes. This is one of the important thing, and people ask you this thing. You can have name of it, for example, status code for the person request, right? And after that, it will have a function here. You can call it a function here, right? So this is the typical structure looks like. And this is the automatically code that they have given, right? Awesome. Yes. So let's understand this part. Now, suppose I want to verify if the status code of the request that is coming is 200 or not, right? I can use PM dot response. So we'll have let's say if we have it, right? PM dot response. So response dot, you can have more like two dot have, these are like already made kind of a functions available to you, right? So if you see, we have, you can directly do PM dot response to have status code of 200, right? So let's run this. And if you see, we have 200 okay here, and time is basically 14 milliseconds. This is a local server that I am running. Size is 1.24 KB, right? I can also save the response if I want to. I can save the save as example. I don't want as of now. Where is my this thing? Let's save it. Right, back to the request, right? I can save it. I can save to a particular file, right? I can save it. If I do the saving part, it will be in JSON, right? And this is your first request. This is your first API test where we are checking for the status code. Now you can add more thing, right? For example, you can check for JSON value, right? If you click this part, you can have JSON. You can write the test case here, JSON value. Right, and here if you see, we have pm.response.json. It will return the full response of this. For example, it will return this thing, and we are basically adding to a particular variable, right? Again, the syntax is very much similar to the JavaScript. If you have worked, right, in JavaScript we create variable by using variable var, var keyword, right? And this is the name of it, for example, JSON data. And after that, we have pm.response.json that we have, right? Now let's basically check out the JSON, what we call it, JSON pathfinder. Let's suppose we say that, right? Right. So if you see, we have five objects, right? And we have first name. So if you see, we can directly use, this is an array which where index is zero, first name. If you want to check the get the first name, which is DSDS, right, you can use this syntax, right? And suppose I want to get this thing, suppose I want to get the fourth one, address Chicago, I can directly use this one syntax, right? So this is a handy way to do that. Let's see some chats. How to see the test results? Can you increase the font? Can you increase the font? Let me check. Yes. Zoom in. This is good. Damodar, this is good. Awesome. How to see the test results? Yes, we can see the test results here in this tab. If you see, test result tab is there, right? You will see all the old result, pass, only skipped one, for failed. So we have a status code for person request 200. It basically means everything is passing. Let's suppose if it is 201, and if I send this, it will fail, right? It will basically telling you that you are expecting 201, but I got 200. Right, so our test case is failing in that case. Why we are getting 200 requests, 200 status code here, guys? This by because this is a successful request, right? And 200 series basically means successful. Yes. In the test result tab, it will show pass. Yes, Vinay. Yes, right. So this is the first test that we have done. Please understand this. Please understand that PM is an object, and these are the method that we are using. Test. You can use pm.response and it has already inbuilt JSON, which will basically give you this thing overall. Now you can use PM regular span can be used to expect. Yes, there is another way you can basically check for that. Sort of. Right. So you can to check out, for example, to you to check your expectations, right? You required a actual result and expected result, right? So this is how most of the testing works, right? We basically check for expected. We are checking whatever the expectation that we have, what is the actual result that we are checking, right? So you can use pm.expect, and after that it will basically tell you what is the value and any message that you want to add. Right. So what we can do is that, for example, we have JSON data. This is a JSON that we are getting. For example, I want to check the first name, right? So the index will be 0 because we are going with the first one, and you can use square brackets and add a first name. Now we can check for 2.equal, right? We have equals, right? So all these have a different things. For example, let's say if we want to do equal and first name is this thing. Let's add our second test case. So we can remove this thing. So we are checking JSON value check. Let's say our test case is check for the first index first name. So you can name whatever that you want. Let's send it. If you see it is passing, it means everything works fine. So let's change it and see if it is failing, right? So it is failing here. Right. If you're able to understand, type 2 in the comment, guys. After that, we'll move to more advanced stuff. If you're able to get it, how you can write your test cases, because you are going to write the test cases for the sign in, register, and the currency after this. And we're going to tell you what are the test cases. Right. So these are two test cases that we have added. Can we customize them? Yes, you can. You can basically add. So let's check if we can add it. Yes. Right. So assertion, yes. Here you can check it out. Change if you want to. No. Right. If you can have a no here. Right. You can do that. But again, this is a syntax of your test case. If you see test case name, you can change here if you want to. Test case. Or to verify first name. If you see here, if you say that, basically you can add verify here. If you want to make it more structural, right? It will be like this: test case 2, assertion error, verify first name, expected this failing, right? So that's how you can customize it. Can we run batch of these test cases? What do you mean by batch? Here, yes, if you are saying that, okay, you can add more. Yes, you can add more here, something like this.
Can we traverse the check for first name on entire array instead of providing the integer?
Yes, we can do that. What you can do is basically, now it's upon you, right? Here you can write your logic, right? You can write whatever the logic you want. You can traverse, for example, if you can, you can use for each loop here, right? And you can basically traverse on the JSON data and check out if the name is the same, rename, if ith value or for example zeroth value for this one is equal to this or not, right? So that's where that's again depends on you. You can iterate here. Here you can write the logic here and do some expectation. So that's what you can do, right? So important point here to learn is that how do I get the JSON? You can get the JSON using pm.respond.json, and how do I parse the JSON, right? So you can parse by using this thing. And if you're writing the for each loop, you can do something like this, right? For example, you can write for each loop, and after that, I'm just writing a pseudocode. I don't want to write it. And so you can check it like something like this, right? Makes sense, right? And here you can check it out. Here you can add more logic, whatever. For example, I want to check if ith value of this is equal to this, then I want to do certain more things, right? That's all. So again, it depends upon your intent, how you write the logic here, right? But my point here is that you can do how you can leverage the, right? So again, it totally depends how you can use the variables here. Make sense, right? So that's how you can write your test scripts. This is again, the important point here is this, whenever we are using, so like presentify present, yes. So this tab again, I'm telling you, it's a post script after the request is done. So we are working here in this part. We are working when our, we have a response, whenever we have a response, right? But suppose in the pre-request, I want to create a random variable, right? Suppose I want to write met.random, right? I want to create some, okay, why it is like this, right? I want to create a random variable that I'll be using probably in the URL, right? Or probably using in the next request, somewhere else I want to use it, right? In the pre-request script, you can do that. It is pretty much similar to the setup request, right? If I work with automation framework, before making a request, you want to have certain kind of a variables, right? You want to have certain variables, for example, random variables, random utils. You want to fetch certain data from a CSV file, you can use that. And interesting part is that these tabs that you are seeing, prerequisite, basically support multiple node modules, right? So you can use the different modules. So let's see which modules Postman supports. Postman prerequisite module support. So if reference external libraries, let me see where we can do that. There's a particular list of, let's see, Postman chai library. So you can use certain libraries. Let me find that. Okay. Let me find it out in a bit, right? No, don't worry. So basically what I mean is that you can use here chai library, which is chai, which is used for assertion, right? Not in the prerequisites, guys. You can use it here, basically in the test script, whenever you have a response, you can use certain node modules here, right? So node modules related to converting base 64 to 64, right? A couple of file reading and all that you can use here. In the prerequisite, basically you can have any kind of a variable that you want to create before making any kind of request. So before making, after making, before making, after making, before and after. Just make sure you understand this. If you are able to understand the pre-request script, test request, type one in the comment, guys, because now because you will be writing the test cases for the assignment that we have given you, and we're going to give you the test cases and you have to write it. If you're not able to do that, post it in the Facebook group. You're going to answer it. Guys, try to use the Facebook group, because Facebook chats are basically more accessible, and but WhatsApp, sometimes we miss it. We cannot share long code, and it's very difficult to understand the different syntax in WhatsApp. Try to use the Facebook if possible. Right. So let's see. Right. So you can have you can use different Postman objects. We're gonna cover one by one. We can have variables. So different variables that you can use. We have environment, collection variable, global. You can use PM.response that we have used. You can use PM.request. You can basically use iteration data to work with CSV file. You can use PM.cookies. Some of the authentication requires a cookie. So suppose you have a login API. After the username password, they will basically give you a cookie. If you have seen the authentication token, it works in a similar way. You have to set the cookie in the next request to work it. Right, so certain API works like this, so you can use that. Cookie jar is nothing but a collection of cookies. Test we have used already. It is basically used to create a test cases in test tab of a Postman. Expect is basically used for expectation and assertions. Request to be, again, it's a kind of a similar to the assertion, where you can check for pre-built methods like status code and other type of a data object that you want to verify. Right. Let's come to the important point, which is variables, guys. And trust me, if you're able to understand the variables and CRUD in Postman, you are done most of the thing, right? So how variable works in Postman is very simple. We have global variables. Global variables are the variable which are basically available and throughout your Postman tool that you have opened in the workspace, right? And for example, I have created a global variable of a URL, right? That URL will be available everywhere, right? You can have this is actually a scope of it. You can have a collection variable. So collection variable will be available in the collection. For example, if you have two collections, then the collection variables are not shared, right? If you want to share it, you can use global, right? So you can go upwards in that case. You can have environment based variables, which are basically available in environments. Whenever you will set the environment for that collection, it will be available. If you unset the environment, it will not be available. You can have data-based, right? Data variables, like we have for CSV file, if you want to do it, right? You can have local variable, which is like available in the tab of test and pre-request, right? So this is local variable. Let me show you how local variable looks. So this is the local variable. This is local variable that we have created. It is available only here for this request, right? And this is the diagram for it. If you see how you can use it, if you want to use the global variable pm.globals.set and set, you can use set and get. If you want to use collections, you can use pm.collections. In environment, you can use pm.environment. Set and get, two methods are there for to set the variable and get the variable. We can use variables for setting and getting, which are temporary in a nature. And again, see the highest preference. Globals have the lowest preference most of the time, but here most of the time we have used global variables to for URL authentication, because our token, we want to make it a global so that everyone in the everyone's consecutive request can use that one. Right? Can you please share the PPT post per session? Of course, yes. Right. So how we are going to use the variables, straightforward, that I have told you, right? PM.globals set. If you are using for the engineering AI that we have used, right, you can set the global variable there rather than environment, because authentication token, if you want to share it in your another collection or somewhere, you can set to globals, right? You can use that in environment also, or you can make it collection, depending upon you. It's totally depend on you how you can use it. More secure way will be using it in a collection way, right? Only that collection of engineering AI that we have created, that you can use it, right? So you can use set method. Set requires key value pair. What is the key? What is the value? Similarly, we have get method. You just need to give the key. It will basically return the value, right? And how you can access it, any kind of a variable. So you can use this this thing, which is called as this brackets, and you can type the name of the bracket in that case. Yeah, yes. And you can print out the variables also. If you want to, you can use console.log. We have certain dynamic variables in Postman which are automatically created. You don't have to set them. If you do $GUID, it will return a GUID. GUID is nothing but a 16 character kind of a string, which is very unique. And right, sometimes you need a unique name, unique something, unique ID that you want to create, right? Session IDs, and you can use this timestamp. If you want to use the current timestamp, it is in Unix timestamp, so it will be like 1504 and something like this in a seconds. You can use random integer. It will basically return from 0 to 1000, right? That you can use. Awesome. So scripts, how scripts works? We have collection first. If you have added anything in a pre-request script, it will run first. After that, we have folders. We have normal request. After that, we'll have collection, folder, and request. Why dollar is there? Dollar is basically, it basically means these are internal dynamic variable of Postman. We don't have to set them. We just have to use them directly. That's why they are dollar. Right. So how you can write a Postman test that I have already told you. tm.test, first is test name, and after there is a function. After that, in here you can write your test cases using pm.expect, pm.response to have, and you can use further. All right, so let's see a couple of more test cases. I have a simple example of a GitHub repo API, right? So this what exactly is happening is that in GitHub you can create repos, right? Repos are nothing but you can say where you will basically store your code, right? So we have given this API example, and I'm gonna share the link with you so you can play around. And don't worry guys, we're gonna have some more details about it. I just wanted to show you what kind of test cases that you can write in Postman, right? So if you see, the first test that we have written is the response time. So we want to make sure that whatever the time that this request is taking, right, it should be below the 1000. So this is a typical kind of a BDD. If you have seen behavior driven, right, it's pretty much looks similar to this one, right? So we have pm.expect what you are expecting. So we're gonna type that pm.response response time. So whatever the response time that we are getting, we are checking it with our expectation that it should be below the 1000 seconds. Similarly, one of the important test case for your API is your content type. You should check that your headers, so basically response, whatever the response is coming, not request, response is coming, it should have a content type as a key in header. Right, so it basically servers should give you in a response what type of content they are basically giving you, right? You can have status code like okay or 200, right? And this is the value that we have already seen, right? So let me check if I have some more test cases, and we're gonna use some pre-request to create variables, right? Content type in sense of JSON. So content type is one of the important headers. What are headers actually? Headers are nothing but a certain kind of a meta information about your request. They are in a key value pair where you will basically tell the server, or server will tell you that content type JSON, it basically means I am sending you a JSON request. So please browser understand this. I'm sending you a JSON request. Content type can be text, a simple text or plain file. It can be octets, it can be binary files, right? So it can be different ways. Most of the time you will be working with content type. How you can set it, you can go to the headers tab, and here if you want to send it, you can type content type, and you will see if you type application, you can basically mention XML, JSON, JavaScript. Octet screens are basically used for binaries to send the upload files. OGG is a kind of a tiny music file PDF. RSS, XML, SOAP, right? So like a couple of more. Even you can tell them it's a zip file or a gunzip file. It's a type of a GraphQL. When we are making a GraphQL request, you can tell the server that I'm sending you a GraphQL request. Audio, like if you're sending images, you can tell the content type as images, right? So they're like multiple ones. When we are sending form data also, you can select the multi-part, right? Multi-part mix, they're like form data, couple of more things. We can understand one by one. Yes. Right. So let's remove this. Yeah. So let's do one thing, the assignment that we have done, right? So I have already prepared, but let me create a new collection in front of you. So let's say it is Engineer AI. Because and we are not going to add any kind of authorization, no prescript, no test case, no variables. We are not using any kind of a collection variable, collection thing. So this is Engineering AI. We don't have any requests, right? So let's open these where it is. Staging.engineeringai. Let's go to the home, right? Please follow along. Try out. Okay, there's a maintenance going on. Oh man,